Hey guys, welcome back to Paradigm Shift Tarot. I'm Dev Topa. I'm an astrologer, also tarot reader. In this channel, we discuss astrology, tarot readings, and all other stuff. So, if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe and comment down below. So, I upload astrology videos. I upload, tarot readings. That's what we are gonna do today. It is a tarot reading for you guys. Will they contact you? So, this could be an ex. This could be an office boss who will contact you for your work. This could be an old friend that you have been missing for so long. This could be anyone, okay? So, as always, there will be three things that you have to choose any one. And the one you will choose, the timestamps will be given below. In the description box, you have to just click the timestamp and we will just see your reading. So, your reading is about, will they contact you? Will they contact you in the coming future or anytime soon? One thing you need to keep in your mind that these are general readings. This could be a crush as well. So this could be anything. Anyone. Except from like maybe someone you don't want to contact. So these are general readings. So they might not resonate for all of you. But if they do, just watch the video for fun, okay? And let's see, there will be three stones. You have to choose any one. Let's see. Here are your three stones, group one, group two, and group three. Choose any one of these and we will see your reading. Okay, pile number one, if you guys have chose this stone, I don't know if you can see it, yeah. If you guys have chosen this stone, this is for you. So then let's see if they will contact you or not. Ace of Swords reverse, Knight of Pentacles. I feel like even if they will contact you, they could contact you, but it is gonna take some time. So this person could be a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn, or they could be in generally very, you know, time taker. They don't do things fast, okay? So yes, this could take some time. So if you can see this card, I'll just show you. This is Knight of Pentacles, okay? This is a card of, this is a very slow moving energy, and also with this Ace of Swords reverse, okay, even if they will contact you and communicate with you, I feel like it won't be much clear. And I feel like this person also have something to tell. I feel like there could be a miscommunication or something that you want to know from them. And even if they will contact you, but they won't tell you the truth. So this could be possible, this person will contact you and say lies. And also with Mother Mary, the unicorns are blessing you. Yes, you are blessed. The Christ opened the door up to the kingdom of heaven. Okay, with these two cards, okay, with these two cards, I feel like you need to focus on something new, okay? I feel like there are more opportunities. You are very, very blessed. And I feel like you are a very kind soul. You just, you know, love people. You just love giving to people. You have very nourishing and nurturing energy to you. And I feel like this person, whoever it is, has some sort of issues. This could be like this person is a sadist. This person has some bipolar symptoms. And you are this person who just takes care of them, tries to heal them. But I feel like this person till yet is very unknown of their own life path and are very ignorant of the emotions that they possess. And this person could lie in even like in the shortest and smallest matters. They could just lie to you on your face and you just know that this person is lying to me. And for now, if you are waiting for this person, just spirits are saying open your door to other possibilities. Open your door to dating. Open your door to other things, okay? Open your door to some new love opportunities and some new, maybe not love opportunities only, do something that keeps you happy. It doesn't have to be a relationship. This could be some sort of work that you want to do, some sort of hobbies that you like, okay? Do that and just don't wait upon this person, because this person is very slow, okay? So even if they will contact you, it could take up to like 3 to 6 months or even a year. So they will take time, and whenever they will come, it will be very like untruthful. Even they will like won't say the truth. So yes, for group one there is a possibility of them contacting, but I don't think they will just say the things that you want them to say or things that you have asked from them or the truth that you want to know, okay? So they won't talk to you clearly. They will have some, you know, hidden things. They won't say it clearly and they will still hide things from you. and maybe lie, okay? So yes, they could contact, but it could take some time, 3 to 6 months or even a year. And in generally, this person is very, has some sort of commitment issues or has lying issues. They just can't help it, they just lie, because I feel like there has been some issues in their past. This could even be possible. Okay, so my next pile is this beautiful pink color stone people. So let's see what is there in your cards. Will they contact you or not? So let's see your cards. Your cards say the 8 of swords and justice reversed. This could be a Libra or this could be an air sign like a Gemini, Libra or Aquarius. And with this birth, the be receptive of a new idea, child or situation, wishes. Be careful what you wish for, as one wish will be granted. Oh my guys, if you are wishing for this person to contact, I feel like they will contact. Okay, I feel like this person finds things very imbalanced in their life, or there is something in their life going on that is very imbalanced at the moment, and they need to balance that thing out. In generally, this person could be little, you know, a character who is not balanced, okay? And there could be some issues in your relationship regarding balance, equal give and take. Maybe you feel like you give more than you receive. I think we all feel that at some point. But this person is very much stuck on you, and this person doesn't want to leave you. This person thinks about you a lot. I can see that, because eight of swords is the card of being stuck, feeling stuck with someone, stuck in the memories. They are very stuck. They want to communicate, they want to talk about something, but I feel like something in their life is still not right, okay? Something is there in their life is still imbalanced. This could be some situation related to their finances, their business. Something is not balanced, and they need to balance it at first before making the move with you. But if you are wishing for this person to talk to you, there is possibility. Just be careful, you could get pregnant either with this person or in general, or you could be prone to pregnancy at this point. And be receptive of new ideas and childhood situations. So if see this person, whoever you are thinking about right now, will they contact you, could contact you, but I feel like there could be also a new love that is approaching your life. Okay, as you can see the card, it says birth. I don't know if you can see it, I'll try to make you see it. This says birth, and if a birth card is coming out with wishes, there could be of course someone new coming into your life with all the wishes that you have, maybe your dream person. So even if this person will contact you, I think either you could move on, or you could already have someone who is actually very much interested, or you actually now have someone who is very much interested in you. And if you're wishing for someone as well, they could come and contact you, because they are very much stuck. They are still stuck in the memory lane. But I feel like something in their hand, something is not in their hand, okay? Maybe with, let's take an example. Maybe they want to communicate and contact with you, but you are already with someone or in a relationship. Or this could be like they want to talk to you, but they have some boundaries. Maybe they are married. Maybe their finances are not right at the time. Or there are some issues from their family. That's why they can't contact, but very much within they want to contact you, and they are still stuck on you. Also, your wishes that you are making right now, one of them will come true, as it says. So expect it within 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 weeks, 8 months or 8 days. Could be even possible that this person will contact, or some sort of wish of yours will come through, okay? And I feel like you could be even receiving money or gifts from someone, or there could be a new romantic partner approaching to you and maybe giving you some gifts, taking you on dates. Yeah, and this is your reading. They could, like, you know, they could give you sunflowers or something yellow. They could wear yellow, the new man, okay? The new person could wear yellow. And whoever this new person is very caring and protective of you, and will be protective of you. And as for your old partner, I feel like they're clearing something in their way before they come to you. I think there is some sort of obstruction they need to clear and then come to you. So this is possible. So this was your reading, pile number 2. If it resonated, yes, they can contact. It could be 8 days, 8 weeks or 8 months. Even this could be a wish of yours that will come true within this time period. Let me know in the comment section if it resonated. Keep in mind, these are general readings, so they might not resonate for all of you. Also, contact me if you want some personal tarot reading. Bye! Pile number 3, if you guys have chose this stone, this reading is for you. For those of you who have chose the third stone, oh, let's see what is there in your cards. Will they contact you? Let's see. Pile number 3. Wheel of Fortune reversed and the King of Swords. Laughter, this person is very rude, or they could be into some media communication, talkative. They could be a little, logical and sometimes not listening to their heart. So they're a very logical person. So they make decisions from their head, not from their heart, which is not a good thing. At least me being a spiritual person, I always prefer you to listen to your heart more than anything else in this world. But this person seems like a very, childlike person. I feel like this person, though they seem to be very logical and they try to be very mature, but they have some sort of childlike innocence to them. The Wheel of Fortune is in reverse. So I feel like this person could be from your past or with someone you had some relationship before. And I feel like this person is not much good for your overall well-being, okay? They could be a little toxic and they could bring some things of past that are not good, okay? And I feel like with this person, you never had a very fortunate relationship, or you guys might not have the fortune of, understanding each other, being together. There is some sort of, either they are very rude or something, because or they could be into profession where they need to be very vocal and rude. And with this Wheel of Fortune, since Wheel of Fortune is reversed, it talks about some sort of blockage in communication, some sort of cycle that needs to be ended. So I feel like even if this person will contact or not, I feel like this relationship with them is very karmic, and you realize that inside, that this relationship is karmic. And sometimes you wish for them to come back, but sometimes you just want to escape this. You just don't want to be in this relationship. You just want to get rid of the feelings that you have, because maybe they have not been helpful towards you or may not have helped you in your overall life. The moment you are with this person, maybe it feels good inside, you are happy. I see a lot of happy memories between you two, and this person may be funny, makes you laugh, or you could be the person who is very funny and makes them laugh. But I feel like there is something in your past that needs to be resolved, and no matter how many times you guys try, it is never resolved, okay? And also, this person could have some foundations or boundaries, or they like putting you in boundaries and some obstructions. They don't let you be free in some way, or they could just be very protective about you. Protective to a level where you can't breathe. You feel like they are just consuming your energy. But they are very funny people. Laughter attracts unicorns. I feel like they love your smile, or you could love their smile. And maybe right now at the moment they are just focusing on the memories, good memories that you two have. I see this person being very very on their mind, okay? I think they have a very heart, a very loving and childish heart, but they don't listen to their heart. They're very like, no, I'll go by my mind. I will just listen to my logic. I just know what my logic says. I'll just go by that. And also they're very argumentative. So sometimes maybe you're saying something emotional, they will bring something practical in it. Also, magic, there is a magic around you, so expect an excitement and joy. Okay, so with this card, I feel like they could be wishing you on your birthday or in some sort of celebration. They could even invite you for some sort of a celebration, or you could be wishing them on birthday, and that's how you guys will start contacting each other. And I feel like, yes, they do wish for you, okay? They know that you are almost like a wish come true, but the problem with them is they can't communicate it, because whenever the emotions are trying to come out of their mouth, they just go by their mind, and their mind just obstructs them, their logic just obstructs them and don't let them say the things that they want to say. So it could even be like they have something in their heart, but when they say, they can't express it properly because they are being way too practical, which is not needed at the situation. And with this you know, there is a magic around you, so expect excitement and joy. This person is a very magical person. They have a very magical aura, their, you know, way of speaking. Yes, they could be sometimes very intimidating, but almost they have a very, you know, very tricky way of talking. They are very diplomatic. So even if they are saying something bad to you, you won't really understand, but later on you will go to home and you're like, did they just say something mean to me? They could just be a person who wants to say something nice, but no matter what they say, they always have this sarcasm in their, you know, way of talking, and that's why people misunderstand them, and you could misunderstand them too. You could have children with this person, or this person could love children. You could have a cat, or this person could have a cat, or have some love for the animals. Also, I feel like this person do want to come to you, okay, do want to come to you, but I feel like if, like, the way they want to come is very logical, it's very hardcore, and it's not full of emotions, because they don't just listen to their emotions. But yes, this person could come back around, but I feel like this time may things just repeat again, just the way they repeated before. So there could be some pattern in your relationship that just keeps coming back and keeps repeating. So if that is the case, you just need to heal it. Okay, you just need to have the trust on him, and he needs to, or she needs to have the trust on you, and you guys could talk it out, work it out, and but yes, there could be some repetition. I don't know what kind of repetition and what situation on what perspective, but yes, it's some repetition according to these two cards. And yes, very much they could contact you for inviting in something, or in your birthday, or you could be contacting them in your, on your birthday. So this is very possible. If it resonated for you guys, let me know down in the comment section below. And remember, these are general readings, so they may not resonate for all of you, but if they do, yes, subscribe, please do that. So bye, take care guys, I'll see you in my next video. Mm-hmm.